All right, hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Holy Potatoes, We're in Space. So, I guess we might as well just look around for a bit. So, 7 large, 8 large, hostile, I don't know about the rest. We might as well go for our objective and see what we can get. Unfortunately, we're a little bit on the... Let me see if I can reload. Load game. Okay, last hub visit. There we go. Yeah, why waste time? Okay, wow, that is a seamless load. Alright, so, yeah. I totally forgot to actually stop by here and see what we can buy. So let's start with upgrades. So, crafting workshop. Meh, not that useful. Definitely want to get bridge level 8. 200 HP to every weapon. Very, very worthwhile. Don't care too much about the research lab, because, yeah, we don't need extra slots. I don't have enough people for it. Hull bonus wouldn't be bad. Storage, don't care that much. You. Increases my max charge capacity. That's not that great. Okay. Let's do shield per turn. Wow, these are getting pricey. Then again, the guns are probably going to be worth it. Okay, speaking of guns... What level are they? 7? Awesome. So I'm gonna... Wow, the price for the blueprints is rough. And the charge cost is pretty high, too. Yeah, so what we want to do is get a succubus with a low energy cost. I'm halfway tempted to actually buy, like, several blueprints for the off chance that we'll actually get a good one. Yeah, a lot of these are decent guns, but kind of rough to make. Well, worst comes to worst, we sell those succubi back for pretty much the same cost. Okay, we want plasma. 200 plasma. Let's make it 200 more. Spend all of my money. We're gonna go make a bunch anyway. I hope. Okay. So, now that they're that, these guys are training. How many more days? 2 souls left. Ugh. Alright. Well, let's go over here, see what we can scrounge up. I mean, we're not in a bad spot. We're just, I've been trying to find replacements for my weapons for a while now, and we kind of haven't. Well, alright, let's explore. Hope for the best. But yeah, most of my guns are from several galaxies back. Which is unfortunate. Why is this guy's shield huge? Oh, shield on, shield all. Oh, absorbs 30% damage to all parts of the ship. Interesting. So he's slightly different from the other varieties. Okay. Well, what do we got here? We've got a gene beam.
Let's see. A bat.
Wow, these are gonna suck to fight. Let's go for the gene beam just because its DPS is probably the highest. But yeah, this guy having shields on across the board is gonna be rough. Do I have the ability to do that? I don't think I do. Cause yeah, I'd probably get that if I could. Maybe. Well, at least we've still got the strength to probably be okay. I just have to be very careful along the way. Not to mention, after every combat, one of our guns comes back. Plus, we can intentionally resurrect some of our guns too, which is also super helpful. So I think we'll be fine. I just worried. I mean, the other thing we could eventually look into doing is actually replacing these guns with higher tier ones that just cost more. It's not great, but it's better than nothing. At least my weapons will heal up between combat, and we've also heavily impacted his firepower already, so it's not a big deal. I think part of it is this game is intentionally designed around the concept of... this game's heavily designed around the concept of, you know, managing losing your guns and stuff. And I pretty much have not lost a single one. We definitely need to find some more accurate guns. I love my Gatecrasher, but it's kind of no good at this point. I also want to see if we can get another Nocturnal Stalker. Unfortunately, they're unique, so I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get any more. Okay, there we go. And thank you for your contributions. Well, we got a pea shooter level 8 part. That's useful. Okay, so this Pickle Man has no shields. A lot of flamethrowers, though. Oh. Didn't realize Burn Baby Burn was a railgun. Let's hit the goop, probably. I don't entirely have a plan here, but it'll be okay. Oh, we took damage from that. Yeah. Yeah. Going for this is probably the good plan. Let's do that. There we go. Okay. Cool. Since we can change it to darkness, you can't have multiple weather effects, which is actually probably for the best. Slot 2, I don't know if it's going to matter. Actually, let's use Purify instead. Okay, there we go. Makes my life a little bit easier. Unfortunately, it hurts my charge a little bit. We got enough for these. All right. Well, I mean, he doesn't have any shields, so that helps. Unfortunately, yeah, we just always miss with the Gatecrasher, so I'll probably replace that at some point. Maybe sooner than later. I like railguns, but it might be a better idea to almost get another, like, laser person and get a pea shooter, something a little bit more consistent. Especially because at this point, a solid pea shooter would be better than our Gatecrasher, even though it's the thing I'd, like, lean on the most, as far as damage goes. I still like the creeping darkness. That's one thing I'm kind of grumpy about. Replacing creeping darkness is gonna suck a bit. I guess I could always leave that for last, maybe. But main thing is I do want to get a higher level succubus. Because if we can get a high level succubus, we should be able to heal our ship a fair bit better. I guess we could also get stuff like the Burn Baby Burn. Fortunately, status effects are not exactly my favorite thing. Just because these battles tend to be a little bit faster. This isn't Halcyon 6. Which, all things considered, I should probably go back and finish at some point. It's just so hard to finish anything. Especially, like, long games. That's always rough. Well, I'll figure it out. I don't know, I have three games that came out today that I want to cover, and two more coming out tomorrow, and early March. I don't know, the idea of going back to anything. I love it how, like, a couple episodes ago, I was trying to consider, like, games to play just to kind of fill space and time. And now I'm just like, no. No more games. It's too late. The reckoning has come. It's, my life is interesting. Okay. Well, we'll just keep blasting and smashing our way through here. It'll take a while, but won't take that long. And there we go. Thank you for your cash contributions. Yeah, the nice part is we're stupid rich, so I'm kind of free to do whatever I want. These are new. What are these? Phoenix Fire. Heals all parts of the ship for 100% of this weapon's attack. Oh, jeez, that's really good. 157, 173. That's not that great, but this does the lowest. I don't know. Either way, let's take out this first, probably. At least none of these guys have shields to get in my way, but kind of rough business. Should probably look into the accuracy of it. It's super accurate too. Oof. I don't know. I don't know which is going to be better. Unfortunately, there's two of them, so me trying to take them off is a little bit harder. All right. Well, let's see. Yeah, heals all seems useful. I wonder if you actually got four of those. If that actually be better or not. Oh, you know what? No, there's one thing I should probably look at for this thing. Charge required 5. Yeah, that's rough. Because I want to say we get 10 charge. A little over 10 charge per round. I think we get 11 charge back. 12. Okay. So I could actually up my usage by 2. Alright. I'll consider that. Oh, also, if you kill something beforehand, your guns don't fire. I'm just realizing the Green Devil Dreadnought has been taking damage. That's actually kind of neat. Actually, that you will, if the target is dead, all of the guns will immediately aim at the main body of the ship. That's a nice feature. Oh, there we go. Thank you for the money. We don't need the gas ever again, because we've actually got some fuel tank upgrades, so it doesn't matter so much. Okay, it's the cats. Lure them in with ore. We get Stone Cold level 8. Okay. Not entirely sure I remember what that one does. Burn, baby, burn. No, we probably want heat-seeking goop done. Railguns are scary, but waves are probably more obnoxious. Okay, you and you on this one, and then the rest on this. Okay. I've also got the consideration of, should we do the story? I think I'm just going to leave the story mission here for later. Like, once we're down a little bit. Mainly, I just want to get some actually good guns in here. Oh, maybe I should, maybe after an exploration or two, we should actually fly back to the station. I can't get any more crew, but I think we already got a crew quarter upgrade. But actually, either getting another craftsman might not be a bad idea, or looking into getting another type of gunner. Because we've got missiles, we've got lasers, we've got rail guns, but it might not be a bad idea to actually get my hands on somebody that can do, like, waves, for example. Which is kind of what I was looking into. The only problem with waves is they drop in usefulness, but I guess so do missiles. I don't know. I'll think on it. We got a lot of recipes from that, though. And a lot of money. Okay. Yeah, the one other thing I could do, I guess. Let's just ignore it for a bit. Okay, so we have laser pointer. No, we want succubi. I could just pass a day. Kind of don't want to, though. Do we explore again? I guess we might as well. The only reason why I would pass a day, really, is if I wanted to just train. Because at some point I really actually should train these guys up. Oh god, they're... Actually, they're kind of garbage. Like this guy, Cucumber. Ugh. He definitely needs some new skills. Do we travel? Let's travel for a bit. Let's see if we can get that boost. We're not in big trouble, but it's not a bad thing. I don't know. Great job, Greenhorn. Probably made superior succubi. Okay. Damage is better. Well, seems worth throwing on. Okay, so that gives us better healing. What else do we have? We've actually got like a billion things here and there. We do have a new missile that I can throw on. We got this. We've got burn, baby, burn. Unfortunately, we need things with low charge requirements, which is a bit on the rough side. Okay, let's do burn, baby, burn. You. Oh, shoot. Before I left, I should have probably trained here. All right, whatever. Let's make a pea shooter. Let's see if I can get a... Let's see. So there's nothing for crew quarters, correct? Correct. Let's see what we got. So he's got missiles. We've got lasers. Waves. Margaret Hatcher. And missiles again. So do we want to... Do we want to pick up Judge Spud? It would give me another laser. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to hire Judge Spud. We want another combat guy. And you know what? Let's get Saitamago. This way we get two characters that I can switch in and out freely. So currently these guys are useless. So let's learn him a new skill. Learn him a new skill. Okay. So this is going to be a bit of a financial drain. The reason why we want to do this is this way I have some more people that I can switch in and out so we can actually get some training done. So let's get rid of the burn baby burn, which, wow, that actually really does make a fair amount of money. Let's get rid of the sucker puncher. It's a missile. Is it... Huh. I mean, the damage is nice from the Apollo, but it's not actually worth it over the sucker puncher. 20% chance to mark versus 20% chance to strengthen each weapon. Ooh. That's a pretty heavy hit to the power, so let's actually not do that. All right, there we go. So I've got money again. Let's go back to the ship. Let's travel. And let's explore. Okay, so having these extra combat people is a good idea. Oh, I should have done science. Hold on. Let's not waste any days here. Plus, it cost me almost nothing. Except for this dumb... Oh. Deadly peace shooter. I mean, it's good. It's just that cost. I mean, unless we replace the ferocious... Nocturnal Stalker with the Deadly Pea Shooter. That damage is pretty substantial, but I don't know. I'm not feeling it. Let's reload. From latest hub visit. We can do this, can't we? That's funny. Okay, let's see. You. Science. What do we even have left? We have greater refinement. That's pricey. Okay, and let's try again. So we want to do pea shooter. Oh. Let's go back. I'd rather waste a little bit of time and not lose these guys. Okay. Plus, this gives me a level, S-level thing that we can work with. Okay, so let's get... Another succubus. I guess another burn baby burn. Yeah. There's no real rush to get this along the way, so let's get refinement. We're rich. Life is looking good. Okay, let's explore. I'm going to be spending a fair amount of time exploring here, just while we update our systems. Luckily, it's not that big of a deal. Okay. Hey, young lady, I see that you have the potential to be a great martial artist. Do you want to buy a martial arts manual? I've got great selection, only a highly affordable price of... All right, I'll take it. I got plenty of money. And we get a Venom Spike level 8. I don't know if that's worth it, but we can recoup some of the costs, and honestly, I want as many blueprints as I can possibly nab. All right, let's go for the... Let's go for the pea shooter. So we might also, when we go back to town, we might also want to get that generator upgrade... just because. Because currently we're not burning through our power, but I believe if we increase our maximum power, our starting power is going to be higher. At least I think that's the case. It'd be nice if we could actually get a gene beam here. 50% chance to shoot twice is actually better than just using a regular pea shooter. I just haven't had the, luck of having a good one from what I remember. And ideally, I'd like to get some replacements that are cheap. Because, yeah, we're getting like 12-ish power per turn. Yeah, we're slowly going up there. But I'd like to actually reduce my power costs. Because that way we'd actually be able to use these abilities, sort of. But we're still in a better position than we were when we started this. So I'm gonna call it close enough. And we also get, like, crazy money so I can afford upgrades and all sorts of other things. I don't know. I'm just... Yeah, there's the gene beam. What we might also want to look into is just, upgrading our... We might want to look into upgrading our, Oh. No, it wouldn't have mattered. We wouldn't have gotten the special effect. Jeez, what was I gonna upgrade? Oh yeah, upgrading our crew. Part of the problem we've been running into is I have not trained these guys to be better at what they do. So, like, specifically, he's garbage. I just have him because he has, like, a slight bonus, but I'm probably gonna switch him out at a moment's notice. This is the only problem is, if I do so, we're gonna need heavier power for it. I guess we could always, like, sit around grinding out gun recipes for a little while. Could work. I think she's first on the chopping block. We just gotta find another gun that has a charge of 2. I don't know how, like, we got so lucky earlier and so unlucky later on at this point, but the sheer benefit of having so many cheap guns to fire has spoiled me in an inconvenient way. No, we'll figure it out. At least we're getting... at least we're on a T8 large planet. That means, I want to say 6 explorations, which really isn't actually that much more. Gravity beam emitter. Defense down, gives itself attack up for 3 turns. Unique. Alright, well the other ones are not so useful, so let's aim for the gravity beam. I wonder if the missile hits the shield multiple times. Doesn't seem like the missile's worth firing when they're shielded across the board. At least not as much. But yeah, I've just gotten spoiled at not having to worry about power as much as I have. And now we're kind of paying the price. Not too much, but it does suck a bit. Let's see, we'll just fire her. But yeah, I'll probably nix her first as soon as we get some kind of upgrade. Because, yeah, her damage is low. Then again, she does low damage because there's splash damage for everything. Which I want to say the splash damage for everything is actually, like, it's almost 100% splash. But it might be 50%. I'd really have to look into it. Unfortunately, there's also not... we only did 60 damage. Yeah, I'll probably nix missiles in favor of a wave or whatever. What I want to do is actually find, oh yeah, we want to find a character that has a charge requirement reduction. I don't think any of these guys have it, but I'll go looking. Every once in a while you can find a crew member that will reduce the charge requirement of a gun by like 25%. If I could get that, that actually could be really good. Anyway. Look at how much Brachiosaur has grown, Faye. I'm a cute little Brachiosaur. Let's go for a walkie-walkie. Cassie walks off with Brachiosaur at her side, Faye trailing behind with a disgusted look on her face. Do you really need to talk like that? Huh? Someone's coming over. Hey, you! I, Junkster Poey, challenge you to a potato Potomon battle. Go, my top percentage Rattato! The potato boy in a red cap throws out a red ball, and from which a rat-like creature pops out. Faye raises an eyebrow at the sight. Cassie happily coos over how cute it is, and... At least until it attacks Brachiosaur. What? No one attacks my Brachiosaur and gets away with it. Brachiosaur, use Vine Smack. Vines emerge from Brachiosaur's back and smack the Rattato away. The Rattato is knocked out. Spud, yeah! I'm the Pokemon Master! Great job, Brachiosaur! The Potato Boy concedes defeat and gives a sum of starch to Cassie before running away crying. Brachiosaur starts to grow a bright light, blinding Cassie and Faye. When the light fades away, Brachiosaur is evolved into Hedorosaur. Woo! That's so cool! Alright. Yeah, I really want to play a Monster Collection game by these guys. I think it would actually be really funny. Alright, let's lure them in. We get a purifier. And exploration complete. Okay, we are fairly rich. Not quite as much from that one, but that's okay. I don't know, we got 32,000 from that. That actually was pretty good. Okay, charge requirement high. Bad high. Okay, gene beam. And let's see, do we wanna let's go missile. A purifier. 2x its base damage to hull. Oh wait, that's kinda garbage. Alright. Let's put him on the venom thingamadoo. We're probably also gonna have to do a supply trip after one more exploration. Yeah, let's do it. Okay. This'll let us get to see, this'll let us get to see what the fruits of our labors are like. Actually, no, we want Creeping Darkness. We always want to fire Creeping Darkness. I'm definitely, when we get, well, there it goes. When we get back to the hub, I think I'm gonna sit down and, see if I can find another Creeping Darkness, to get my hands on. Like, I will dump a lot of money on replacing one of these if I could. It'd also be really nice if you could actually just update them. Like, that actually would be really cool if you could pay, like, a fee and have a chance of upgrading your guns. Because I don't mind the level system in this game, but it turns the game into kind of a constant gear treadmill. I really like FTL a lot. And one of the main perks of that is generally, every gun is viable in some way, shape, or form. There are obviously, like, major differences, and some guns are clearly superior. But, like, you generally can kind of make it work with everything. I don't know. I guess, ultimately, they're kind of incomparable apart from, base design concept, I guess? I don't know. You know, the flying ships, getting parts, upgrading your ship, stuff like that. But, I mean, I'd say this has just as much in common with, I will admit, I do miss the boarding mechanics. Boarding is, like, probably one of my favorite things about, Boarding is probably one of my favorite things about, of FTL. Just going in and wiping out people's crew, or, like, specifically doing weird things to control, where their crew goes and, like, what they do. It was always fun for me. I don't know. Okay, let's see. Take it out. Nope! We are missing constantly. I really want to take out that gene beam, but, yeah, we really do need to replace this sucker. Even with the accuracy bonus from Creeping Darkness, it just, the Gate Crasher has such bad accuracy. It's a high crit chance, though, is great. Oh yeah, that's part of the reason why I've been keeping it around. You really can't compete with a 30% crit chance. I don't know. I'll look into replacements. Still, consistency would be rather nice. Okay. We're getting tons of blueprints. I like this planet, actually. Souls, give us your souls! What the? Alright. So we want to play Dark Souls again. I guess, really, I should just be playing Nioh. Nioh's about as good. Oh, God, I need to play Nioh today. Today is a day. Today is not my day. Oh, that's fine. Let's shield up this one. Yeah, it's fine. some point I'll figure my life out better. At least I've got like a crazy amount of backlog for at least several series. That's always kind of a helpful little bit. It's like, sure, I'm in a position where I'm just swamped with games. But I'm also in a position where we're not, like, too screwed. Alright, let's set these two on this one. And these two over here. Let's see. Also kind of hope this game ends soon. I don't like this game, don't get me wrong. I assume the devs are watching this. I really do enjoy it. It's just, to some degree, the repetition has gotten to the point where it's just like, well, there's no end in sight, and so either we could be like 10 chapters from finishing or 2, and I'd have no way of knowing. Are you stunned? No, you're not stunned. I just misclicked or something. I'm not entirely sure. At least we've gotten to kind of like a perfect situation for like knowing what we're doing and whatnot. Okay, so these are soap spray. Don't care too much about soap spray. Let's go for the foghorn. Interesting point. I'm realizing, I have all 4 guns and I can pretty much fire them reliably. Most enemies only have 3 and they only generally fire like 1 or 2 of them at a time. That's actually a huge plus as far as I'm concerned. I guess she can fire 2 of them. Or he. Kind of hard to tell. Yeah, they only fired 1. Then again, I just blew off the other one, so I guess it kind of makes sense. I do like the back and forth though, the balancing of like where you shield and stuff like that. I almost wish it was actually in real time though. The turn-basedness isn't that big of a problem. But it's one of those where it's like, I could actually see this working really well in like FTL style real time with pausing, so if you need to like move things around. But like if every gun had a different like speed differential, charge, stuff like that. Oh yeah, that'd be perfect. Charge would be how fast they fire. Oh, hello.